between. Everything that exists in the universe is dispersed by his decree. He's infinitely supreme and orchestrates all things. The one who sits in the heavens and laughs and does whatever he pleases. Who governs the governments and establishes kings. The prince of peace who precedes over prophets, presidents, and priests. Who guides the plans of man but lets that man choose freely, while simultaneously exercising divine sovereignty. Who intervenes on the will of man and causes for man to believe. Who appeases the wrath of God that brings peace to his enemies. The Lord over lords and the King over all earthly kings. The pervasive power of God displayed through his mighty deeds. The God of our destiny, the author and finisher of faith, with the power to persuade man and sway souls for God's sake. The ultimate source of authority who rules with mercy and grace, but man reduces this attribute to foolish debate. Righteous in all his ways and never wrong. Who is God sovereign? Who is awesome? Who do all men depend on for life and breath? The author of life and death, the often overlooked, but still he's all-seeing, all-knowing, holding all creation in its place, the God of wrath and grace, the one who can crush every idol man would rather chase, and leads men to the narrow gate through these crooked paths we navigate. This world exists cause you commanded it, so is your hand in it, or have you handed it over to man then turned away and abandoned it? Did you try your best and then left man to handle the rest? Will your plans find success, or should we second guess? When world leaders are deceivers, eager to puff their chests, is life a game of chess? Do you have these kings in check? With so much evil, how can we believe you're good? But I finally understood when I saw that man nailed to wood.